Evaluated as Toastmaster Rajesh Narayanan. For this, the evaluator is DTM Nina John. Every time I hear the name DTM Nina John, the first adjective that comes to my mind is delicious. The delicious cake she served offered for her birthday. And I'm equally confident her evaluation will also be delicious. Watch out. Please welcome DTM Nina John.
But when we die, we hope that others are crying and we can live. So full circle as far as that is concerned. Excellent way of having a speech from beginning to end. So they're great points. As far as this particular project is concerned, although it comes under the first five projects, which most people think are common projects and, you know, very simple projects, it's only after five that the difficult projects start. Project four is actually the foundation for the rest of your projects. Because all our speeches are based on words. So how do we pick the right words? How do we say that? What are the tips, the tools, and the techniques that we can use simply by changing the order of words, changing the emphasis of certain words, changing the sentence structure, and using words to enhance the imagery, the ideas, and the concepts that we are planting in the audience's mind. So using the right words makes all the difference to the kind of image or idea or concept that we have in our minds and that we are trying to communicate to the audience. In this particular case, I think Rajesh chose a very appropriate topic because he had a story, there was dialogue, there was drama, and there was plenty of scope for vivid description. By and large, good, simple words, but I think in a couple of places, the sentences were a little convoluted. When we have longer sentences, as when we have the entire anecdote about the neighbor, we tend to go, and then, and then, and then. Shorter sentences. My mother said, go with the neighbor. And I said, no. Instead of saying, I refuse, and then I said this, and then all those things. Keep it short, keep it crisp. The impact becomes much more. So sentences being shorter add to any kind of drama and dialogue. Again, good similes, like a villain in a Tamil movie. Again, in terms of crisper usage, a villain is enough. All of us know what villains are like, regardless of whether they're in Tamil, Hindi, or English movies. So this is why he was like, a villain is enough. So keep your sentences shorter, crisper, and it adds impact over there. Using triads, simply for the sake of using triads, can sometimes be a little cliched. Dejected, disappointed, any of those things. We've heard these pretty often. So try and get something that's a little new. Add freshness to your dialogue, and it makes a difference to that. One of the good metaphors I liked, starved from studying. Instead of saying, I felt I was starved, or I felt as if I'd been deprived. Starved from studying was a beautiful metaphor that we used over there. And yes, I am disqualified. The use of props. I like the way you use your props. The sandalwood was excellent, but I think in a place like this, maybe you can do a little cheating. Use a little sandalwood powder because we couldn't get the smell of the aroma of the sandalwood in the back. So just have it there and just do that over there. Little cheating is allowed for all these things. And great touches of humor, as for example, in the mother's and the sister's reactions. The sister being very happy, bringing that ruler out was brilliant. I mean, everyone could empathize with that.
And then the mother beating up the sister for not empathizing with her mother, you know, icing on the cake for that reason. So that was absolutely brilliant. And overall, I liked your general language is excellent, but then the whole point of this project is that we should avoid any kind of grammatical mistakes because I think, as Gauri Shankar said in his presentation, even, you know, other audiences will not forgive you for that. So the title itself, Live Like Sandalwoods, is a grammatical mistake. It should be just sandalwood, singular. So we tend to make all these mistakes where we have jargons, feedbacks. We just people just add S whenever they feel like it. They're already collective nouns. We don't need to add S to that. So overall, I think you can go ahead with the kind of language you have, good foundation, but use it to enhance and improve the impact of your speech on your audience. Good job.